गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर. द चैप्टर नेम इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटम एंड द सब टॉपिक इज बोहर्स मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम. सो रदरफोर्ड ही गेव द पोस्टुलेट्स फॉर द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एन एटम बट ही हैज ऑल्सो सम ड्रॉबैक्स एंड दोज ड्रॉबैक्स आर समहाउ रिमूव्ड बाई दिस बोहर्स मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम. So what are the postulates of Bohr's model of an atom? What is the theory about the structure of an atom that is given by the Bohr? We will discuss that. Bohr said only a fixed number of orbits they are possible for each atom. Like hydrogen will have certain number of orbits, oxygen will have certain number of orbits, and these orbits are known as the discrete orbits. So the first point that is given by the Bohr is only certain number of orbits are possible for each atom, and these orbits are known as discrete orbits. When an electron, Rutherford said, electron is revolving around the nucleus in orbits. Yes, it was true. When an electron is revolving in an orbit, Bohr said it will never lose the energy. So the drawback of Rutherford that an electron will fall into the nucleus when its all energy is exhausted has gone wrong. So this is the fact. It never lose energy. The second name of orbits is shells. You can say shells or you can say orbits. According to Bohr, these shells, they are also known as energy levels. And which shells are possible? K shell is there. First shell name is K shell. Second shell name is L shell. And third shell name is M shell. And fourth shell name is N shell. So N equals to 1 is the orbit number 1. N equals to 2 is the orbit number 2, N equals to 3 is the orbit number 3. So orbits are represented by alphabets K, L, M, N, or orbit number N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, or you can say it's their orbit number. So this is the Bohr's theory about the structure of an atom. So next topic according to your book is neutron. There was a person whose name is J. Chadwick. He said, apart from electron and proton that are present in an atom, another subatomic particle whose name is neutron is also present in the atom. The neutron is having no charge on it, but its mass is similar to, nearly approximately it's equal to proton. But its mass is approximately equal to proton. Charge is zero, no charge. Remember this point. Neutron has no charge, but its mass is nearly equal to the mass of the proton. So in an atom, and neutrons, they are also present in the nucleus, and we know protons are also present in the nucleus. The sum of the masses of all the neutrons and the sum of masses of all the protons, they all make the mass of an atom. If you say, now what is the mass of an atom? It is the sum of the mass of all protons and the mass of all neutrons is equal to the mass of an atom. So this is the concept of neutron. 4.3. How are electrons distributed in different orbits or shells? We know different orbits are possible, such as K, L, M, N. How they are being distributed around the nucleus? So this idea was given by two scientists whose name was Bohr and Bury. So they have given some rules that are used nowadays also for placing electrons in various shells. So first rule was, maximum number of electrons that can be placed in a shell is 2n square, where n is the orbit number. You know, for k orbit it is 1, for l orbit it is 2, and for m orbit it is 3, and for n orbit it is 4. 2n square. So you can calculate mathematically. K shell means n equals to 1, so electrons, maximum electrons will be 2. So in K shell, maximum 2 electrons can be placed. So in L shell, maximum 8 electrons can be placed. So in M shell, 18 electrons can be placed. And in N shell, 32 electrons can be placed. But maximum 8 electrons, this is a rule number second, maximum 8 electrons can be placed in the outermost shell. Suppose there are 3 shells, K, L, M. So M is the outermost shell, so maximum 8 electrons can be placed here. Once the K orbit is filled, then L orbit will start filling out. Once the L orbit has already filled, then the M orbit will start filling out. So lower orbits will be filled first, then the higher orbits will start filling. So this is the third rule. So you should remember some atoms in the previous chapter, structure, atoms and molecules. It is there, hydrogen, helium, lithium, these are the elements, and they are having atomic number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. High heels liye bina bhi kal nani aur fufi nachengi. You can also remember this. High heels liye bina bhi kal nani aur fufi nachengi. So atomic number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there will be only one orbit and one electron. Two electrons, one orbit, K orbit will be there, and two electrons can be placed in K orbit. 3 is the atomic number, 3 electrons are there. So there will be two shells, K shell, L shell. In K, two electrons are there, and L, one electron is there. In case of this beryllium, atomic number is 4, so 4 electrons are there. 2 can be placed in K shell, 2 can be placed in L shell. Similarly, there are 8 electrons are there, so K shell will accommodate 2 electrons and L shell will accommodate 6 electrons. But you know that the capacity of L shell is 8. However, it is accommodating 6. So this is the way that we have studied first Bohr's model of an atom. So orbits are possible, he said, energy levels. K orbit, L orbit, M orbit, N orbit. J. Chadwick is the person who discovered the neutron. And this neutron is having no charge, but its mass is nearly equal to the mass of proton, and it is present in the nucleus. So what are the rules for placing the electrons in different orbits that is given by Bohr and Bury? Maximum in an orbit 2n square and 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Lower will fill first, then the higher will start filling out. So thank you. Have a nice day.